Are these things on?
Oh my god!
It's okay.
Take two.
Oh my goodness. Money, you sold me. I love my friends are like my programmers.
Is that what she said?
She's like, I think your mic is still on.
Oh, no.
Oh my goodness, Lucy. I gotta stop saying that because I don't wanna be That was some funny, funny business.
Yeah, so we can kind of we can kind of improvise. You said.
Oh yeah, of course.
All right, I'll try to get into it. I'll try to. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Wow. How about that? You guys, I'm so sorry, Lucas. I'm going to have to play your song again next week because apparently I forgot to mute the mics. And so everybody got to hear the whole conversation that was going on over here. Thank God I didn't say anything crazy. At least I don't think I did. That was funny. Lucas, we will play. Actually, send me another song, and we're gonna play a different one next week. It was beautiful, nice, right?
Uh-huh.
Beautiful.
It was soothing.
And
yes.
Very soothing, and yeah. For all the love that's gonna go on in the air with the forgiveness thing. Mm. So this weekend, let's see. Well, you shared some of this weekend with me. We had a good time.
We did.
It was action packed. It's always an action packed weekend. What we do?
I fully enjoyed finally going to disco and hearing real disco.
Yes. So there's a new club called Disco, which we went once, and the floor is like Saturday Night Live, like the whole
Saturday
Night
Fever.
Saturday Night Fever. It lights up. It's really cool, you know. The crowd is, you know.
So. The space actually reminds me of somewhere like in Miami.
Yeah,
like the colors and the brightness of it.
Yeah. So, but we've only been there like a handful of times, right?
Mm-hmm.
And each time we've gone in, there's no freaking disco.
It's all remix of disco. It's not original disco.
Yeah, I mean, hello, the club is called Disco. I thought so. Anyway, this.
How do you like define disco? Like, you meaning like?
Well, if the floor is gonna look like Saturday Night Fever, it doesn't have to be that. That kind of disco.
No, but real disco, not like the remix stuff. We're
right.
talking about the originals. That's
exactly.
what I'm speaking of. And Ron Carroll definitely brought it.
Ron Carroll.
So he put a kind of like a modern twist to it.
Ron Carroll. I'm sorry, I was laughing at something. Ron Carroll. Yes, definitely. He gave us some disco to
he
dance
did.
To. We appreciate it. Happy birthday, happy belated birthday, Vic Lavender.
Yes.
And I said that last week. Well, his birthday just passed. And Ron Carroll, I think, we just had a gathering. And Friday,
my days went into one.
I know, I went to see, I went live. I went to this place called Stereo.
Okay.
And damn it, I left the CD in the car. But I wanted to play a tune from the CD because my boy J2 and Sean Owens have a once a month there. It's in Logan Square. It's called Stereo. Almost like. never mind.
She's in her head again.
yeah, really cute. I was hesitant to go in because it looked like a crowded hipster, like just a lot of.
Where was it at?
Logan Square, like
okay.
by Milwaukee, California.
Okay.
It looked like it was going to be like that, yuppie hipster, all that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I went in to go show some love and support because I was invited. And I was pleasantly surprised. It wasn't super crowded. It was a nice crowd, but the layout was kind of like a church.
Is this where I saw the pictures that you were with PJ?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So, the music was really good. They do a lot of like soul classics. They do some disco, but
okay.
So, and I'm pleasantly surprised. A lot of like old Spanish songs too. So,
nice.
And they have a CD called, it's a mixed CD of their, you know, compilation of songs that they play. Called Funk y Fuego.
Oh.
I like it,
mm.
right? I like the title and the cover. I left it in the car. But Yes, Funky Fuego. So like they do once a month, and it was this past Friday. Mm-hmm. I went there, had a great time, and I went to go see JV, James Vincent, spin at the mansion. Charles Little, oh my God.
Oh, no.
Charles Little, if you're listening, you find you. Your name just popped up. I met Charles Maddock. Had you guys, wait, the first time I had a guest here, mm-hmm. it was Vivian Garcia and John Clay. The whole show, I kept calling him Jack. And he would not say anything. And aww. I was like, wait a minute. Your name's not Jack. It's John. He has a business called Vivwell. But anyway, back to the weekend. James Vincent was spinning. Some good house music. And I went to go see 3 Degrees had something at Annex. So I heard Felix spin.
Oh, yeah. How was that?
It was nice. Yeah.
It's
weird because it's the old Red Dog.
Yes.
So the energy is... You know, I mean, it's totally, obviously, totally different crowd, mm-hmm. different.
But you can still see, like, how it used to be.
Yeah.
So,
mm-hmm.
but yeah.
It still kind of feels like that.
Mm-hmm. Especially so, upstairs.
Yeah.
All the way up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, it was cool. It was nice. Action packed. And then, yesterday I spent a great day with my sister, my friend Vianney's birthday. We were at London House, which was
I heard so much about it, but it's not, I've yet to go.
I think it's overrated.
Is there beautiful views or
beautiful
what?
View, yes. The rooftop,
okay.
Beautiful view. I think it's overpriced, overrated.
How was the service?
Wow.
Really?
What? You guys understand that?
Wow.
Went there, and I went to a whole bunch of places I normally don't go to. Went to Disco, met up with you there, and went to the Tunnel, which... So weird that there's a tunnel.
Yeah.
And did you know we had a country bar downtown?
Well, I know that there's some other bars like in that area that also plays country. Joji is very into that.
Who?
Joji.
Really?
Yeah.
Joji, it's a country. So, yeah, did that. Seven, I think, and Untitled.
And how was that, Untitled?
It was really crowded.
Okay. How was the music?
It was good.
Really? Do we know who's spinning?
I don't know who that was.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was really crowded. It was okay, you know. I mean, it was okay. I wasn't wanting to choke myself. You know. Get
yeah.
out of here.
Yeah.
Can't take it anymore, but it was cool. It was alright. It was nice bumping into people. But, okay. Enough about my week. Oh, and then today, my friend Norma, she owns Shadow Emporium in Pilsen, and it's on 21st Street, 20.
Just west of Ashland.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So she had a Earth Day celebration, and people brought in stuff to plant. It was like one big hippie party in the yard. Drummers and vendors. And, my friend Yvonne Nieves, she was doing tarot card readings and Akashic Record readings, which she's going to come on the show sometime. And
I dug her.
Readings.
She's super cool.
Yeah, very beautiful person. She's a Reiki healer and she's very into a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful being. So I will let you know about her stuff too, in case you want to get some readings. And I did chair massages, and they sold oils and soaps and all kinds of stuff, tea and everything. So it was a beautiful, beautiful gathering for today. And I just came straight from there. So hi.
I'm about to go live, girl.
Yeah, live. I know I didn't go live yet, but I will. So anyway, so Jerome.
Yes.
Hi.
How
are
you doing?
Hi. Jerome is an amazing, amazing, amazing trumpet player. And we're going to listen to him play in a little bit. Play a tune.
I'm excited.
Right?
Sure.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes, he's amazing. And you have a band now, right?
Yes, I do. And
called Trio of Life.
Yes. Let's say a band consisting of I originally had a guitar player, a lead guitar player, and what I'm starting to realize that bringing a trap drummer in, along with a bass player, gives it a kind of an interesting dynamic. And because what I've been doing is I've been going back and forth on trumpet and keys, you know, in our annual rehearsals. And, you know, we kind of wanted to, what we wanted to do with the group is we sort of wanted to bridge the gap with the traditional, you know, jazz and I guess Afro-Cuban rhythmic background, along with the blues, pop, and funk, and rock rhythms that we definitely relate to, nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like a live experiment. We improvise at the same time we play melodic. We play melodies that people, I guess, enjoy. You know.
Yeah. That's what Jerome looks like.
Oh yes.
Uh-huh. And,
all right.
And, live on Gypsy Love Radio. So I know you moved away for a little while,
mm-hmm.
right? And you moved to New York for a while?
Yes, I did. I was living in East Flatbush, Brooklyn, and it was a fantastic experience. During the day I was teaching in Queens. It was crazy because my commute was about an hour and a half.
Oh my God. An hour?
Hour and a half.
What were you teaching?
I was teaching music in an elementary school. We were dealing with drums and melodicas. And it was interesting because we ended up putting together, we recruited some students from middle school who were also dealing with recorders. So we kind of put together like an interesting folk orchestral ensemble.
With the kids?
It was pretty good. Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, very cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I felt like that was probably the most significant part of my trip in New York, because it was like, it was hard to get into teaching younger students in the past. Like, before I would focus more on maybe more mature, experienced students, but there I learned how to pretty much teach any age, you know, all ages.
How long were you there?
I was there 2 years.
Okay. And how long ago was that?
This is
he just moved
recent.
Back.
Oh,
I just
yeah?
moved back in July.
Woo-hoo.
2016.
And I'm happy.
Yeah, well, we're happy you're back.
Yeah,
but,
and he's going to be playing in the Foundation Room at House of Blues.
Yay.
And that's going to be on May 3rd
yes.
from 8 to 10 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
So you can come hear him perform live in the Foundation Room at the House of Blues, 329 North Dearborn. On the fourth floor, you got to be 21,
mm-hmm.
and there's no cover. We get to come and get listen to some great music. When did you start getting into music?
I started playing in my elementary school band when I was 10 years old. But of course, before that, you know, I just had an inclination to play music. I mean, as far as back as I can remember, like, I would always be, you know, playing on something, whether it be pots, or my mom, depending on what was going on in the house. If we were cleaning up, I'd turn the mop bucket around, you know, come up with some interesting sounds. Even when I went to bed, like, I felt like my whole body was always active, you know, and I felt like the experience of music before I even picked up the instrument, you know, and but when I finally got into music, I mean, that just helped me bring out some of the things that were, you know, swimming around in my brain growing up.
So it became like a healing.
Oh, definitely.
Right? Healing mechanism. Tool.
Yeah. Because it's like, when you think about it, like music, you know, is so, you know, clear. It requires a lot of, you know, you have to basically let go of some of the things that you're dealing with so you can focus on the music. Like, I remember a band instructor told me one time, like, you know, when, I mean, you prepare in the practice room, when you come to rehearse, you know, you're getting it together, but the true test is, you know, in the day of performance, are you able to zero in on the task and not let too many things distract you.
Like
you come back to the distractions after
this right now.
Right.
Oh, video.
Yeah.
That type of distraction. So and do you have any weekly play anywhere else you're playing? Or any shows coming up?
Well, I will be at 90 Miles Cafe in the Lincolnwood vicinity.
We love 90 Miles. I've never been to that one yet.
No, but they have live. I haven't been to that one either. I passed by.
Yeah.
But I heard that they have some pretty good music, live music there.
Yeah. Wow.
So you're going to go play?
I'm going to be playing.
Maybe we'll have to come check
out.
Yeah. You're going to let us know when you're going to. What day?
The 29th. I believe that's Saturday.
Saturday the 29th?
Day or night?
That's nighttime.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, we'll take Mika there too.
Mm-hmm.
Mika is a little Aries princess. And Anna's daughter. And she's graduating from Shy Arts, right?
Shy Arts, yeah. And she got accepted at our institute. We're very proud of her.
Yes. So
Mika.
Yes.
Sweet.
Yes. So do you let me introduce Anna, since we just mentioned the foundation room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's Anna, and I'm sure if you're watching my video, you've seen her before.
Definitely.
And Kayvon over there, hi. He's got a Fresh Air Network Podcast Studios, so you can log on and check him out too and see all the great, amazing podcast shows he's got going on there, including this one.
Yep.
And so, Anna.
Yep.
So this is one of my best friends, and she is the director in the foundation room.
Yep.
And she works a lot.
I do work a lot, but I'm grateful that I have off tonight and I'm able to be here.
I know, thank goodness.
Yeah, if I'm not working, I'm usually at home with the kids and family, but I'm definitely happy to be here. But this all plays a role in what I do too, though, right?
Yep.
I feel like we're always working.
Yeah.
Because I've got Yvette who... She's also booking at for me.
Yes.
She's booking right now maybe like 3 or 4 times a month, but we're going to get her in, kind of booking a little bit more. So those of you that are connected with Yvette and you want to perform, go ahead and reach out to her.
You can find me on Facebook, Yvette Magallon, Magallon. You could email me at gypsyloveproductions@outlook.com. And you could get on with Little Rhythms, live, because that's live music.
Yeah.
So all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. And Anna,
yes.
So tell them a little bit about what you do over there.
So besides, it was originally when the foundation was put together, it was originally a private club just for members only. We just recently started opening up to the public. But we still have our member section that you have wonderful, amazing benefits by being a member and paying so much. But so besides taking care of our members, we have a fine dining room downstairs. We do promoter nights.
We do on Tuesday nights, we do comedy with Chicago Comedy with James Camp. Great lineup. I mean, people just show up. You know, like Hannibal Burris shows up on a regular just to kind of try out his acts before he goes on the road. We have DJ Tony, aka my husband, who DJs that night.
Tony!
Tony! And then on Wednesday nights, we have a thing called Sessions from 6 to 8, which is usually an acoustic player that Yvette here books for. And then we do a thing called Windy City Indie, and it's bands that aren't signed to labels yet that come and perform. And you never know who's going to be in the room, you know. And I try to tell all these people that are performing, like, sometimes all the big whips from Live Nation could be just sitting in the room and they could get booked for something else. So you just never know what's going to happen. It's kind of the amazing thing about the room, too. And then on Thursdays, we do sessions again from 6 to 8 with acoustic players. And then from 8 to 10, we do a thing called Foundation Cabaret. And it's kind of a twist of old school variety shows. You could come in and see anything from a contortionist to a little burlesque to a magician to spoken word. So there's a little bit of everything on Thursdays with Foundation Cabaret. Then Fridays and Saturdays, we do a thing called Elevate, where we have local DJs come and spin from 10 to 2 a.m. And then once a month, we do a house or burlesque, which has been very successful, and we sell out with that. So yeah, it's definitely, it's constant there. And especially when we have the main shows in the music hall, we throw the after parties for whoever's performing in the music hall. So, yeah.
Cool. Yeah, just a busy woman. The Foundation Room, really, it's a nice little sexy, intimate lounge.
Kind of like Genie's Bottle. That's what I'd say. You know, like, it kind of looks like that, right? A little bit?
It's a nice place. If you haven't been, you should. Yeah, come visit. So, Mr. Croswell, would you like to play a tune? Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Ready to get your whistle wet?
Yes, I am.
Oh, no. Isn't that, like, I'm bad with those terms, man.
It's okay, bro.
Isn't that your mouth?
Yeah, I guess for...
Isn't your whistler your mouth
for what we're speaking of right now?
I mean,
sure.
It's all relative because, I mean, even when I play the trumpet or the cornet, I definitely have to wet my whistle, too. Just if I don't, I'll be in trouble trying to get those notes out.
Oh, my God. Well, you know, this Kevin over there looked at me crazy like, you said what?
Because you have this thing now, this new thing where people say pause. After they say something that's kind of questionable.
Like that, like what I just...
Yeah, you said it earlier.
Again, right?
Yeah,
I said something earlier.
So you say pause, basically, so if anybody else heard it and may misconstrue, you know that that's not what you meant. You meant it the right way.
So say, do I have to say pause?
Yeah.
Oh.
You don't have to, but that's...
Just pause.
Yeah, so...
What did I say earlier?
We're not going to discuss that.
We're not going to... He said we're not going to go there. We're not going to discuss that.
For real, what did I say?
Pause.
I think you said pause.
I don't remember what I said. I really don't. So, all right, let me turn some of these mics off while you play because it's going to be loud.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, you can leave that on.
Oh,
I'm going to leave yours on. Or should I not leave that one on? I'll leave this one on, maybe?
Let's see. Is it bleeding through?
I think I'm gonna. I could leave this one on, turn that off? Or no?
No, that's okay.
We're sound checking.
Because that.
1, 2.
Yes, so I've decided to take out the, on this tune I'm going to play flugelhorn, which is, it looks exactly, almost like, exactly like a cornet, like a heavier cornet, which is a smaller trumpet, but If you, I kind of wanted to play flugelhorn on this one because this is a horn I like to warm up on, and it's around this time of night, it's like a good horn to mellow out to. Here we go.
Really?
Yes.
Right, here we go. That's a mellow out with my horn. Oh, that's what it was, a hard one. Right?
Pause. There you go.
We're talking about the horn.
Here we go.
Get a picture of you. Foundation Room at House of Blues from mm-hmm. 8 to 10.
Yes.
Earlier that night, same night, we're going to have Molly and John performing. And Molly and John, you've heard them play before, right?
Uh-huh.
It's more like a cabaret.
Yeah. I liked it. It kind of reminded me of the 40s a little bit, some of their stuff.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Wednesday, hello. That same Wednesday, May 3rd, it'll be Molly and John from 6 to 8 p.m. and Jerome from 8 to 10 with the Trio of Life. Yeah, they got a nice little Afro, like Latin jazz fusion thing going on.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. So, all right. So tonight, the topic, I guess I'm going to stick with forgiveness because that's just, it wouldn't leave my brain as much as I wanted to think of something else. It just, that's what it was. That's it. So my friend Huelva, which last time sent me a reading from somebody, sent me this reading a few weeks ago. And it's pretty long. It's okay. I think I should read it. So I'm going to read it to you guys. Okay? All right. So it's my friend Huelva sent this to me. And he's a world music DJ, in case you guys want to know. And right now he's very involved, which I just remembered, the Latin Film Festival's in town. And I haven't been to one movie yet, but I plan on it this whole week. All right, so this is a message from the Pope. That's what it said.
All right.
I don't know why I'm laughing. What's so funny about that? Guys, we're about to go to church. While Anna goes,
sorry, I didn't know. I didn't
playing
mean
her own music on her phone.
I don't mean
to. What the heck is going on over here?
Sorry.
Can I get some respect around here?
Yes. Sorry about
that. I don't know where that came.
It was actually you. It was you that I was playing. I didn't mean to do it.
Oh, okay. We'll play it again.
Oh, then it's all
no
good.
No problem. All right. Hey, Alexi, if you're listening, I love you. I'm sorry I haven't visited with you yet, but I hope to see you before you go back to, where is it? Europe over there, Germany or Amsterdam, or he lives somewhere out there. Anyway, so the message is, you can have defects, be anxious, and live irritated sometimes, but do not forget that your life is the biggest company in the world. Only you can prevent her from going into decline. There are many who appreciate you, admire you, and love you. I would like to remember that to be happy. Wait. I would like you to remember that to be happy is not to have a sky without storms, road without accidents, work without fatigue, relationships without disappointments. To be happy is to find strength in forgiveness, hope in battles, security in the backs of fear, love in disagreements. Being happy is not only valuing the smile, but also reflecting on sadness. It is not just to commemorate success, but to learn lessons in failures.
It's
11
o'clock.
What was that?
Someone's letting you know it's 7 o'clock. I don't know what it sounded like.
You know, this is serious. Okay, so. Back. All right. It is not just to commemorate success, but to learn lessons in failures. It is not just to have joy with applause, but to have joy in anonymity.
Good job.
Sometimes my accent kicks in.
A little bit. It's okay.
To be happy is to recognize that life is worth living. Despite all the challenges, misunderstandings, and periods of crisis, being happy is not a fatality of destiny, but a conquest for those who know how to travel within their own being. To be happy is to stop being a victim of problems and become an actor in one's own history. It is to cross deserts out of itself, but to be able to find an oasis in the recess of your soul, of our soul. It is to thank God every morning for the miracle of life. Being happy is not being afraid of your own feelings. It is knowing how to talk about yourself. It is courage to hear a no. You should not drive. It is safe to receive criticism, even if it is unfair. It is to kiss the children, to pamper parents, and to have poetic moments with friends, even if they hurt us. To be happy is to let the free, happy, and simple creature live within each one of us. It is to have maturity to say I was wrong. It is to have the audacity to say forgive me. It is to have sensitivity to express I need you. And it is to be able to say I love you. May your life become a garden of opportunity to be happy. May you be joyous in your spring. In your winter, you are friend of wisdom. And when you get in the way, start all over again. Then you will be more passionate about life. And you will discover that to be happy is not to have a perfect life, but use tears to water the tolerance. Use the losses to refine the patience. Use flaws to sculpt serenity. Use pain lapping pleasure. Use obstacles to open the windows of intelligence. Never give up. Never give up on the people you love. Never give up on being happy, because life is a must-see. Yes. And that's from Pope Francisco. How about that? Mm-hmm. See, we just had church on Sunday.
Right?
Right?
After
hours. Yeah, right?
After hours.
Nice. Yes.
My
so,
kind of church.
Right? Me too. I like it. So anyway, forgiveness. Why? Why should we forgive? Forgive what? Who? And the benefits of forgiving. I think I've been putting that into practice like the last few years, like really, maybe I've always done it, but being more conscious of forgiving. I think before it's just like, I don't really have time to hold on to any of that. I have other things to do, you know? And, but being able to just say, you know what? I forgive you because you're a human being and mm-hmm. we're not perfect. Mm-hmm. And every moment's perfect. Everyone has their own journey on this planet. But, you know, but forgiving people that may cause harm is a big deal, you know? Like,
it's really hard.
Yeah, I mean, being molested and having forgiveness.
For that, yeah.
For that.
Absolutely.
You know? Abused. Okay. Physically or mentally,
absolutely,
you know, and having to forgive for that.
I think a lot of people have
just reminded me I have to forgive somebody.
All right.
I forgive my ex-husband, right here on the air.
That's beautiful.
In case you didn't know, I was married long time ago.
A long, long time ago.
And you know what, Mister, I forgive you for all that BS.
But see, you, and I think even myself, I think people get kind of caught up with, you know, oh, I can forgive them, but how could I forget? But I don't know that anyone, am I on?
You are on, but you're not talking to me.
I don't know that anyone, I mean, do you really forget it? No, it's always going to stay there, right? But
I think it's what you do with that.
It's what you do with it, right?
Yeah.
Because otherwise, it's just like, it holds you down and it weighs on you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got some people in my life that, you know, family members that they're holding on to things that they don't even know what they're mad about anymore.
I know, you just gotta be mad. It's a habit.
They don't go to family parties, they don't go to this or that because someone else is gonna be there. Like, what?
Right.
You know, that's crazy to me. It's like punishing yourself. But maybe that's their path where they're...
Then what do you do? Like, what else will you do if you're not going to be, you know, mad and holding on to that grudge, you know?
Some people don't know how to live any other way, unfortunately.
You're right.
You know?
Because they're used to having that pain there. Mm-hmm. And it sometimes I think it makes people feel like they exist in some kind of twisted way.
Sure.
Because they, you know, oh, I feel, mm-hmm. you know, when you could replace that with forgiveness and just welcome in some love.
And some lighter feelings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, for sure. So are you working on anything that you are currently maybe forgiving or feel like you need to be forgiven? The world is listening.
I hear. I see. well, this is interesting because I remember carrying, you know, a lot of pain around, like, because I thought that, you know, like, the thing about forgiveness, it's, as long as you take it the thing about pain, I'd say, as long as we take
certain things personally. You know, if someone says something in a mean way, mm-hmm. if we internalize it as like, oh, that's for me, then definitely there's pain, there's, you know. And so, of course, it's hard to, when the me gets hurt, then it's hard to forgive because the me is sensitive. You know, but if we, it's almost like the only way to, it's almost like we have to, sometimes we have to get outside of ourselves and then re-look at the situation. Like, okay, if I was hurt, you know, years back, okay, you know, was this person really trying to hurt me, you know, or is it just that this is what they know, it's a form of communication, or like some people express themselves in a hurtful way, but they feel like this is natural. This is natural.
Mm-hmm. They don't know any better.
Form of communication.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, like, for me to forgive, like, I have to go into the psychology a little bit of the person that, you know, that is hurtful, and then try to get a better idea. Okay, all right. That way, like, I know that it's not, I'm not the, you know, it's like I can go past the victim
mm-hmm.
concept.
Okay. Well, yeah, that's like.
Cause it's because.
Yeah. I hear you. Yeah. Cause that's what I, you know, like, well, I'm gonna use my ex-husband as an example because mm-hmm. I already brought it up. And so he was physically abusive when we were married. And I had to go back and just be like, you know what? It wasn't okay, but, and I'm not finding an excuse for it because there is no excuse, but, you know, the person is going through their own life lessons and journey, you know, mm-hmm. so, you know, what to do. Obviously, he didn't know what to do with that energy, but to let it out in that manner, mm-hmm. you know, and, do I regret that? No, because it all those situations helped me to be more in tune with myself. It brought me more to get to know my spirit more,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I don't regret it.
You have a beautiful son from it.
I do. Yeah. I do have a beautiful son who is a man. Yeah, he's a man now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. My battery's dying on my phone. Tony Cruz, hi. Oh. Where are you, Tony? And hi, Teresa. Hey. Yes, you're right. Teresa was on Facebook and she was talking about how forgetting is hard.
It is.
Because it stays in the back of your.
But being able to separate the two, I think that's even harder, right? That's the challenging part. Being able to.
Yeah.
A lot of people can't do that.
Yeah.
Not that I can all the time either. It's a constant work in progress.
Yeah, it is. For all of us. Yeah. For all of us. So, anything you're working on with forgiveness?
I don't know. I think it's a constant. Because I take things personal and then realize
it had nothing
to do with me.
It wasn't about you.
It wasn't even about me. Although most of the time I think it is, but I know it's not. But, you know, you realize that, then you can separate mm-hmm. that. It's like going through the different layers, right?
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I will definitely think that I do take a lot of things that when I hear hurtful things, and sometimes maybe I'm even taking them that way, but that's not the way that they were meant,
right.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, like I said, it's a work in progress. I can't think of anything right now that I'm, like, holding on to deeply that I, no, that's not true. I do have one thing, now that I'm thinking about it. A family member
uh-huh.
that feels the need to have distance, and I love this person, and I guess all I can do is give them their distance because they need their space for just no reason at all, but just that's what they need in their life right now, to be separated from everyone. And that's hard. Mm-hmm. Then you think, did I do something? What did I do? Mm-hmm. What can I do? How can I make it better? But it's not for me to make better.
Right.
It's their journey, and I need to let it be, which, you know, I'm kind of controlling, so.
Really?
So with that controlling aspect of myself, it's been very challenging to, every time that I want to call or see, how are you? How are you doing? Or check on the person, I'm like, take it back. I need to give them their space and let them be on their path. So me, I'm having to learn to, that's forgiving, because I find myself getting angry too. Like, what?
How dare you not talk to me?
I dare not talk to me. I will not be ignored. You know what I mean? but it's not about me. Again, you know, and like you said, like you can't take the things that you're taking personal, you should not be taking personal, because it probably has nothing to do with you.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But that's about being more, I like to say, awake and being present. You know, I think if this was me 10 years ago, I don't know that I would even be able to, be able to have this conversation without
that's
being
true.
Angry and being
that's
like, you know what I mean? And I just wouldn't have been able to. So at least I feel like I'm more awake.
You're learning.
Yeah.
And you're awake. You're learning, you're more aware.
Mm-hmm. More aware, for sure.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm.
I have my friend Janine Watkins, which she'll be here next week. She's got a new magazine coming out. She'll be coming next week to talk about it. Her own new magazine, and I forgot the name of it.
What is it about?
We're gonna find out when she comes.
Okay.
Yeah. I think it's gonna showcase a lot of similar like stuff that's going on here. But she has a lot of interviews with people and.
Okay.
Yeah, it's nice. I'm proud of her, so I'm happy for her. I'm gonna play a song and then we'll get back. Oh, by the way, you guys, I keep forgetting. If you wanna call in, the number is 312-985-7834. You can call in, give us your input on forgiveness and whatever, share whatever you want to share. So, all right. So, the next song is that I'm going to play is by, I don't know how to say his name, Tarek Gerbatou? Gerbatou. And that's what we're going to hear as soon as.
Let's go.
There we go.
Are the mics muted?
No, they're not.
Can I use the restroom real quick?
Yeah. Oh my god.
So
where's it at, bro? Hold on. I'm gonna see if I find a cup so I can give you some coffee. You want
some? Oh, yeah.
Bye guys. Thanks.
All right. Don't leave us hanging now.
Sharing is caring.
Why?
Oh, I like my coffee.
just coffee.
Pause. I like that. Pause. That's almost like crickets.
It's good flavor too.
It is, right? No, never mind. Just don't spill it.
Stop it right here. I'll be careful.
I wanted to do the freaking Facebook Live. I can't.
Which? I don't have an extra iPhone charger.
Right? Hey, do you have an Android charger?
No, iPhone charger, huh? I have like a car charger, but I don't have
Damn it! The mic was
still on, huh?
Jinx me with that damn I love Lucy thing. Look at me. Oh my god. Oh my god. So crazy. Always forget to look that way, but I don't think anybody's calling anyway. They gave up on me. Oh. Calling in, fucking up the damn calls. One time I was like,
you can't answer.
Oh, the phone's still not. One time the damn. Put somebody on. I was like, ooh, it sounds creepy. And the mic was on. Oh, great, it's on video now. We're totally on video. We've been on video, right?
Right?
Oh, but you said it again.
Can they hear you?
Oh, damn. Oh, my God. That's funny. Sorry. I know, right? It's not. Somebody put it on my Facebook page. I like it because it's like, it's a lot of different elements in it, right? So, this podcast,
like,
I shared it.
Yeah, right?
Live on my wall, or just that part? But I didn't share it once. Okay. Apparently, I left the mic on again, and you guys got to hear me talking. I'm gonna play that song, Loca, Loca, Loca. Yeah, all right, well, I hope you got to enjoy that. That's a beautiful song, right?
It was.
The guy's name, you know, I like all the different components to that song, like all the elements, and like we were saying, I was shocked when the horns came in. I was like, oh, that's a nice little surprise there.
With
the
grand choir there.
Right?
Sounded good.
Yeah, it was very cool. Are you talking to me? Hey!
Hello.
I know, I want to do my... Let's just turn that off. Some background music? Yeah. Alrighty. So, you know, there was another thing I didn't want to talk about. Again, if you want to call in, 312-985-7834. 312-985-7834. I guess I should put that on Facebook so people can see it. But where was I?
You want to talk about something else?
What else did you want to talk about?
Well, I'm trying to remember how it came up, this topic.
Okay.
Because I was. How was I even? Okay. I noticed a friend of mine had his hands in his pants. Like, he kept putting his hands in his pants.
Like, in his pants or in his pockets or in his pants?
In his pants.
Okay.
And I was like, dude, for real, like, can you, like, can you go wash your hands now? Do you have to, like, what is up?
Right?
You know, like, he's like, what? It's nothing. I'm just like, what? Put my hands in my pants. That's what I do. And he goes, man. Then he's telling me that his ex-girlfriend used to get really mad at him.
Yeah.
For putting his hands
in his pants. Like, out in public, putting his hands in his pants.
I didn't ask that question.
Okay.
I guess that makes a difference, too. But I have seen people that are just like always.
Well, but
let me not say people, men.
Yeah, and why is it more acceptable? Wait, well, you see men do it, but God forbid, a woman doing it.
Right, we put our hands in there.
It's more accepted from men.
Why?
Because.
Can you answer that, Jerome?
Yeah.
I felt like
maybe this guy never learned that that's not acceptable. Like it's almost like. You see kids do that, but you know, you're supposed to stop that once you reach 7, 8.
Sure.
but apparently, like, or maybe because, or he could have seen an adult do it, but maybe that, you know, I don't know, he picked up the bad habit.
Do you put your hands in your pants?
I do not put my hand in my pants. Matter of fact, I don't even let my pants slide down past my waist.
Oh, let's not talk about that. That's bad. When I see that, I want to pull up everyone's pants that I see hanging down.
Smack them.
Yeah.
But,
put something in there.
But that's,
I want to be like, here. Pause. I'm learning. Yeah, you know, and I don't want to put my son out there in case anybody's listening.
But you are, so go ahead.
I know he's going to freaking kill me. But he always has his hands in his pants. No, I don't see him do that in public, but in the house. Like
when he's laying there watching TV kind of thing?
Yeah.
My dad and my brothers do the same thing.
But,
Tony
so
doesn't, though,
you
so
agree
much.
With that, Kayvon?
That's
you
private,
put your hands
though,
in your pants, too?
At times, yeah. If I'm at the crib,
yeah.
And then it's not like you. It's a comfortable position, actually.
Mm-hmm. It's a comfortable position.
Yeah. You just keeping them warm.
I wouldn't say that. It's sometimes it's mostly by habit. It's a habit. Yeah.
You don't not just say. Well, I'm asking you, but and you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys? You just put them in the pants,
yeah,
or do you kind of like? You know,
adjust things.
That's a good word, because that's not the word I was going to use, but that's a good word.
Oh, God.
Is it always adjustments going on?
It's two different things that you're asking. One is, do men adjust themselves?
Well, I don't know.
Yes.
I know that they do,
okay?
And that would be the occasional adjustment.
Right.
But no, when you're just like laying there, or like, you, oh,
mm-hmm.
I mean... Like my son, my son will play video games, and next thing you know, I'm like, hands, play video game with one hand, and now he's not doing nothing, you know, like
right.
that, but he's just resting his hand in that comfortable position.
Yeah.
But why? It's so gross. I think it's like, that's, I don't know. And then I feel like you guys don't necessarily go wash your hands right after that.
No.
Don't. Why are you guys pausing?
Why?
Because they're thinking about it.
No.
All right, on to the next topic.
Yeah.
Forgiveness. No, I'm just
kidding. Forgive guys.
I forgive you. I forgive you guys for not washing your hands after you adjust.
Uh-uh.
All right, so. I have a friend of mine who, not that she's a friend, she's a musician, and she sent me this song, and her name is Carla I need to start asking people how to pronounce their names, Carla Campopiano, and she, have you heard of her? No, she's in a group, it's Tango. So she sent me this video of her performance, and I'm gonna play it so you guys could hear. And wait for it.
Take it.
That's my new thing. Wait for it.
Right.
Wait for it. It's fun. I don't know why it's taking so long.
Takes a minute to load.
Oh, maybe if I put the volume.
That'll do it. Don't forget to take off the mic.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they did. Oh, oh my God, Yvette, you're such a loca. Look at this. Okay. How about if I turn?
There you go.
No.
This doesn't sound Tangle-like, though.
All right, people. I'm having some technical difficulties here. You guys need a combination. Okay? Combination. All right. Now you're going to get the tangle. All right. I forgot to turn off the other music. I'm learning, you guys. Remember, this is new. I'm learning, and you're with me. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Let's turn these mics off.
Okay.
What the hell? You guys hear it?
I don't hear anything. Oh. There you go.
I'm glad you guys came. Thank you. I appreciate it.
It kind of goes by quick.
It does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It really does.
They played Rock Temple for me when I was doing Wednesdays.
We
gotta figure out why. I took it out. I'm not sure where I'm going.
Donde estarán aquellos que pasaron dejando a la estrella de sus ojos en la sombra de tiempo y que su nombre, mucho pasión y amor, se acercaron. Los gustos de su leyenda, en la postrera brasa, que a modo de una vaca rosa, guarda algo de esa chusma valerosa de los corrales y valvanera.
All right, that was a live performance that they did, and we'll have them play live in the station in the near future. But that was a live performance that they did at Sabor Café, and that is a Colombian restaurant up north. So let's see. While I am here, I am going to I'm gonna play another song. Because I need to go.
Do it.
You can do it.
You can do it, Mama.
All night. This other one is It's a open mic. It's a poetry. It's a band poetry. It's with Mr. Kahari, and let's play. So.
I heard this little rock star poetry project that Kahari B called himself doing. I wouldn't even waste my time trying to see it. You know, it's probably gonna be trash anyway. It's probably a lackluster effort given out by this dude. Man, who really even knows this dude?
The rock star poetry project sounds like someone gave Helen Keller a microphone, told her to ride an elephant, play the guitar, and some drums, and kill a bunch of monkeys. All on one track.
Last time I listened to it, I looked at the title and it was like some shit about.
So this is an
Indian
intro to
shit.
His show.
I'm listening to it and this shit. This is having me on a motherfucking emotional roller coaster.
Oops.
I'm a gang member, man. I can't be on no emotional roller coasters and shit. I'm happy, I'm sad, I'm want to have a child, I want to go look at flowers. That shit is crazy as hell. You got to be off some cocaine.
Oh my God. Pause. Kahari. Oops.
Check some fine dimes, slipping away with some lanes, wondering why it wasn't like that for me. I've seen it as a crime as I've been passed over for this or that time after time. Guys doing grimy shit, getting all the benefits. Nickel and dime niggas living million-dollar lives. While in the meantime, I live that old paradigm of nice guys finishing behind me. But it's cool. By the time it's bear time, digested daily doses of bullshit with powerful mental insight.
All right, everybody. That is Kahari playing right now. I'm playing one of his songs. And Being Me is the that's what it's called. this is Gypsy Love Radio. I hope that you're listening in. www.que4.org. And if you guys want to call in, the topic for tonight was forgiveness. Also, yeah, it's forgiveness. Thank you. If you want to call in, the number is 312. Oh my God, my face popped. No, I think it's 312-985-7834. 312-985-7834. That's it. I wonder if it's backwards.
It is.
But if I go this. Is it
bad?
I don't know. Anyway, 312-985-7834 if you want to call in. We have Jordan Crossbow is in the house. He plays trumpet live. We have Anna Lezen, Kayvon with Fresh Air. I want to say thank you to Justina for watching. Vivian, thank you for always watching. Again, listen in on the radio station, also, Sonia, Johnny Soto in Miami, Jerry McAllister, thank you guys, Susan and Paula and Marky Mike, got you guys, Mikey. I'm glad you guys are paying attention. There is a podcast that's going to be shown on Fresh Air Network and on my page. You'll be able to see it then. And what else? That's it. This is Gypsy Love Radio. Thank you for tuning in. I love you guys. And we still have some more time on the show. So I think. Joel might play another song a little bit later. Not yet. I keep beating the damn mic side. The songs keep beating like. Hola, George Jimenez. So, anyway, it'll be interesting to see all the conversations that took place while the music was playing and I left the mic on. It's pretty funky, right, this song?
Yeah.
Kahari, that's you playing. I'm playing that song that you have something on Facebook. You said. So, what? Why you laughing? You laughing at me, huh? I'm a clown. I'm gonna joke you.
Well, my hair is a female.
Pause. Oh my goodness. Tony, by the way. Hello. All right. Anna Mezzo's live on Facebook.
Yep.
I'm watching you.
Watching you, bro.
I'm watching you.
Watching me.
Uh-oh. Slave,
right? All right.
Do you have a song request?
I will take a song request.
I'm not that type of DJ.
Okay.
You gotta look it up,
right? What do you want?
What about
Stand up, Harlem Choir.
Done. Man, Kahari, that was hot. I like that track. Gracias. So, we're gonna have another tune. Are you ready to play or you wanna wait a second?
You can wait a second.
Okay, no, that's fine. That's fine. We have things to talk about here. Like, hands in the pants. We talked about that already.
You've got hands in your pants.
You've got your hands in your pants. It's disgusting. Let's see. All right. What else? What else is happening on this planet besides all these people coming together and doing all these beautiful events like the one we just went to? Oh, you came there too. This Thursday. Oh my God, how can I forget? This Thursday. Honestly, I have to cut you off. Sorry, Facebook Live. I got to get some information. But this Thursday, there is a party. My boy Zach is spinning at. I'm going to get you that information right now. Yeah. It's called Sochi Hospitality Group at the Forum, and it's at a place called Cracked 695. It's on 695 North Milwaukee Avenue. I heard it was hot.
Yeah,
so I'm gonna go check it out. There's gonna be DJ and live music.
Beautiful.
This Thursday. So go check it out, April 27th from 6 to 12. And there is a $10 cover at the door and $7 advance. I should have probably saved that for later. Well, all right. So, get my.
Do it.
Hi. So, call in if you want, please. Because because it adds flavor to the show.
Yeah, it does.
And before, people used to call in, but I was always messing up. And now I'm having a hard time getting callers.
They don't love me. Nobody cares.
All right. So See, this is something I got to learn, is how to fill the space up, you know, like when I'm looking for something.
Yeah.
And so if anybody has any clues or tidbits or, you know, something to teach me, because I'm learning on how to, what to do, you know, when I'm looking for something. I mean, I probably should have had it ready already, you know, when I was in baseball.
It looks like he's getting ready.
Things are falling apart.
Right?
Yeah.
Don't, you can't fall. And you said, which song? What song?
Harlem Choir, Stand Up.
Oh, this is a request I'm getting.
Harlem Children Choir? Just look up Harlem's Choir. But you probably want to hear the remix. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It was when we were in Miami, it was last year, it was the song that Joe Clasell ended the night with. It's beautiful.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Actually got... My husband introduced me to this song years ago, who Lewis introduced him to that song. I think I got the story right.
I have a funny feeling that...
You can't pull it up?
It looks like some church songs for real coming up.
No, hold on. So it's called Stand Up. Hold on. Wait. Go.
You know what it looks like?
Yeah.
That's Stand Up for Jesus.
No. So put House Remix. That's what you should put after that.
Okay. See, we're live.
We're live. I'm gonna stop this and come back live for
Look. No. So anyway, you wanna look?
Yeah.
I'll let her look for it because she knows what she's looking for, and I will. In the meantime, did you read it? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. I wanted to go to the trumpet and mess. I put in this harmon mute and change it up a little bit. Let's see what we're working with.
Like it. All right. And is there a name to the song, or is it just something you're playing?
It's like this is my rendition of. Actually, this is in homage to the great Dizzy Gillespie, who, to my knowledge, this is his 100th birthday anniversary this year. So,
wow.
And as a matter of fact, we're having a special performance at the Latin Jazz Fest in Humboldt Park. Definitely going to pay homage to the great Dizzy Gillespie. So we're gonna play one of his tunes called Con Alma.
Con Alma.
Mm-hmm.
Is that like Spanish? Like Con
Spanish.
Alma. That's
like with soul.
Yeah, with soul, with love.
With love.
With heart.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good stuff. All right. Well, let me mute the mics over here.
What
happened?
No. Go ahead.
We're gonna pause. Oh, there you go. All right. Get ready to blow.
Thank you.
That's so cool looking.
It's like, it sort of helps you to stay in the form of of the song. It's almost like the skeleton or the, blueprint of the music.
Like, okay.
Gives it, it's like, it's what the body is made of, I guess, so to speak.
It looks pretty. Complicated. Anna's working like a mad scientist.
Thanks, Tony, for hooking me up, babe. I texted Tony. I was like, babe, what is it?
I was going to tell you, but I didn't want to say it because, we were on, he was playing. Yeah. I was going to be like, can you tell him to go look it up and send it to you or something?
I know.
Because,
I got you. Here you go.
Oh. Wait, this one?
Yeah. Stand on the word, not stand up. I'm a little twisted sometimes.
And then she said, where is the choir?
It's a remix of the Harlem Choir. Legit. It is.
All right. So, this is Larry Levan, Stand on the Word. Great.
Yep.
All right. This is a special request from Anna Leza.
Hello.
Hello. Uh-oh, coffee's kicking in.
I know, it really is. Good thing I did have a culata. Instead of regular coffee.
Oh my God. Okay. So let's play the song. Hold on. Let me make sure everything is in order.
Set it up.
Because, Nice. All right, we're gonna play the song, and we might dance.
We might need to,
right?
The song is beautiful.
Get ready.
Get ready.
All right, everybody. One, two. Oh, I heard this song.
Yes, you knew it. I knew you knew it.
I think we should like.
This is like a beautiful way to kind of end your thing.
Mm-hmm.
You ever heard this before?
I've heard this
before. Beautiful.
You said so. It's a mix.
So the original is the children's chorus. And then Larry, he took it. And we did it.
You know what? Do you mind if I throw some more?
Please do it. Do it. Okay, yeah. Do it.
Going down now. Jerome. such a nice treat.
You were that's a beautiful song, and you were
Oh, that was so nice. Hey, Kat. Hey, Vince. Yes, I guess we went to church a lot today.
We did.
Oh, wait a minute.
Our mics are on?
No, mics are not. Now they're on.
Mics are on. Mics are on. Mics are on.
I know. I have this thing. Mic on, mic off. Mic on, mic off. Mic on, mic off. Oh, man, I stopped the video.
Oh, really?
Listen, oh, well.
I got 14%. Oh. Going down.
Well. Headphones on.
Headphones on. Check.
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 Oh, wait a minute. Is it still going? I think we are still live.
Hmm. You're stuck a little bit, but you're live.
Yeah. All right. Hi, Kat.
Hey, sister.
We got to get you in here so you could dance while the music plays. Sometime.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
She's such an amazing dancer.
She really is.
Oh, man. She, like, fills the room with this great, beautiful, positive energy. She's spinning around and dancing, right?
Yeah, she is beautiful.
She is, yeah.
You can feel it.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for always blessing us with your dance. You want to dance?
Dance.
Would you like to dance? Sometimes I pick up a British accent. Mm. I don't know where it comes from. Anyway, well, everybody, that was a good going away song.
It really was,
like,
right?
Yeah, it's like I don't have to play
it's
anything
like
else.
I feel like I don't need to die. I feel like I'm already in heaven.
Aww.
That's all I need. Sunday night here with Yvette and Anna.
That was after hours church.
Mm-hmm. After hours session. Yep.
Maybe that's gonna be the new name. No. Yeah. So, well, thank you everybody for listening. Mm-hmm. I don't know what's up with my thing is frozen. Pause.
Good job.
Exactly. I'm learning, you see? I'm learning. I want to say goodbye. I want to do it while I'm live on Facebook.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people were watching.
Yeah.
You know, I had a lot of new people watching and stuff like that. And I want to tell everybody to get on the... you want to get on the microphone and tell people where they could...
Yeah.
You want to get on this microphone?
He's got that microphone.
Oh, he's got a mic.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
We all got a mic.
She is that one.
Oh, okay. Look at you. He's like, I'm not showing my face. I can come dressed for that.
He's behind the scenes.
He's behind the scenes, but not really because I keep showing him. And zooming in like that.
Zoom in, zoom in, zoom in.
Oh my God. Hi.
What's happening?
How are you?
Yeah, in Chicago we have a lack of media outlets to actually give people who... You know, they're professionals and experts.
They can't hear you on here.
They can't?
No.
Maybe far away. You might sound too far. Mm-hmm. Get on the microphone.
Right.
Jeez.
Bring them over.
Now you're recording yourself.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Good job. Well, you know.
You have a great voice for radio, too. Mm-hmm.
You know, I did radio.
I
know.
That's right. Yeah. Oh, yeah. This guy has done a lot.
Nice.
And he continues to do a lot.
Well, the reason why Fresh Air Network, you know, I used to do the networking events for several years, and that's why I picked up most of my clients and friends and resources. But it meant...
He picked me up there, too.
He did.
Pause. No, the point is that I've been out here for a while as far as being self-employed, and I've met a lot of people, done a lot of business with them, and people have great ideas and great concepts. But I thought that the challenge was to get that information out to people and get it out to them on a consistent and effective and efficient manner. So instead of just having audio as the number one thing that people utilize to get their, you know, radio was mm-hmm. the first thing that they, media kind of came up with. Mm. But the point is that in Chicago, more or less, we know we have a lot of talent, a lot of great energy, a lot of concept, a lot of kept secrets. You got Chance the Rapper's that's now coming out.
I know.
Nick Jenkins, BJ, the Chicago Kid, just to name a few. But it's some people that, like yourself, who have been doing it for a while and in different facets. But where's the media outlet in which you can actually showcase yourself,
right,
and or get to certain audiences that you would like to, or even, you know, like I said, meet people like Yvette that, you know, through Anna. And so all of those dynamics, I felt that it was something that I needed to do. So Fresh Air Network was, of course, a lifestyle consultant, social media platform, and I graduated that too.
Okay.
When I meet the Yvettes, and we've been friends forever, and we re-meet up. You know how it is.
Every few years.
Yeah, yeah.
But now I think it's gonna be.
Okay. All right. Well, that's the point, is that we like to keep people on the front lobe of our minds, especially in business. But how do you do that? Do you do it just do it on social media? Do you actually have to see them? Do you have to throw a party, an event? Well, most of the time, that is the case for you to actually, you know, get in tune with people that you do business with, or even friends and family. And I think that's sometimes the kiss of death for business owners or entrepreneurs. They want to stay relevant. They always come up with new ideas and always evolving. But when do they have that evolving kind of merge with their markets? And then how do they do that on a consistent basis? So I thought podcasting, which is a new kid on the block.
Yeah, it is. Meaning people are liking it.
It's upcoming everywhere.
At the same time, most people are not doing it, or they're just doing it with their cell phone.
Like right now.
And there's nothing wrong with that, but sometimes quality is key when you're branding yourself, when you're branding your business.
There you go.
When you want to have music that actually can pick up the music that you actually hearing.
Or playing instead of breaking, going here. You know, when you're on Facebook Live, it's like in and out.
It's distorted and whatnot,
So I created a studio, of course, and the studio is where people come, business owners mostly, but most experts, because the business owners actually bring other experts on their show to actually showcase sort of like what's going on here. So what happens is that we get to actually document these experiences that we're having, which is very important. We know that a lot of people have come and gone in Chicago and their story has not been told, or somebody else has to tell it. So why is it that we can't tell our own story while it's going on and document it? And then, of course, that's other ancillary opportunities that comes with that. That means the advertisement, the things that Yvette is doing right now, the things, the places that she go to, the things that she did this weekend. She's actually advertising.
She is.
And creating experiences.
Oh, don't worry about it. We know where we're going with this later.
Yeah.
But
the point being...
It's free right now.
And that's it. The one thing is that we want to create value all the way around. And one of the things I was telling Yvette is that she knows people, and she knows I know people, but how do we merge them together? Or how do they know that we know each other?
Right.
And for this point, you know, this long period of time. And, you know, it's been different facets that we've, you know, when I was doing insurance and all that good stuff, which I still do. The point being is that how do you showcase yourself in a media format in a city like Chicago, where you actually get to showcase the people that you be in contact, your friends, your families, and the concepts, and even like what you were thinking about earlier as far as the show and the concept of the show. These are things that's going on in your life, and you get to actually share them with your loved ones or your friends or your family. Sometimes we just do it on social media, but we're lucky enough to have a platform, which is the radio show and of course our Fresh Air Network, to help it be more visual and more engaging, and actually people get to know you more and you know, love you, and probably, you know, become more fans of you. So that's the piece.
Forgive.
Yeah, so that was the story.
For anything that I may have done this weekend that...
needs forgiving.
You're forgiven.
All those butts I smacked.
Did you hear me? Yeah, you did.
All those butts I did.
Oh, God, help us, you did.
Shh, we're lying.
But that's it, though. I appreciate you giving me the opportunity to share.
Yeah, of course. Why wouldn't I? That's the whole point.
We do. We just need to know that we do have valuable things that's going on in our lives. Sometimes we feel like we are entrepreneurs in our own world, and when we're doing it, we don't necessarily need
think that other people need to know about it.
Mm-hmm.
But we're extraordinary people doing extraordinary things. But
yep,
it's hard for us to actually document it because we're so caught up in the day-to-day, which I am too.
Yeah.
You know, in my day-to-day operations and our businesses. But when you have something like this, at least we can say, hey, this is where I met Hannah from. This is where I met this guy. And, you know, and now you can actually have some kind of blueprint on what kept you relevant, who put you on, why did they, what was the experience like, and that's important because now we're talking about our children and them seeing how certain things have been done so they can get on board and they have, that's yet another market that doesn't have a platform to say what's going on in their heads and their minds. So fresh air is just not for just adults, it's for everybody. And it's for the community as well. So once again, thank you. And
thank you.
Thank you.
Visual diary, if you will.
Yeah.
All right,
good job.
Well done.
Let's get back to work.
Thank you.
Thank you. So you can see this show and amongst other shows that he's got on Fresh Air Network. And this here is Gypsy Love Radio. Thank you guys tuning in. But also log online and listen to the show too. Don't just watch here. Listen online too, please, at www.que4.org. I don't know. Can you see that? I know it's backwards.
You can
There's an exercise
it,
for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Turn it around.
We'll get it right next time.
How do we? There's no way for me to do
it. We're going to do it flipped. We'll write it backwards.
We'll write it
backwards. What is this?
We'll keep the graphics the same, but except the letters.
Yeah, we can do it. We can do it.
That's why I have friends like this.
Just good looking out.
Smart cookies. I'm like,
it's okay.
So can they introduce themselves as they go out so people can continue to follow
them? That's a great idea. So thank you. This is Anna Leza from the Foundation Room at House of Blues. Please come and visit anytime you like.
Don't ask for no free tickets to any shows, okay?
Okay, can I say this one thing, though?
Yeah, please do.
Okay, here's the deal.
Let them know.
You're more than welcome to come as a guest in my room. But please don't ask me for free tickets. And only call me when you want free tickets.
Yeah.
Like, it's exhausting, people. You know, I want to take care of people, but you got to support the cause.
And don't sneak into the shows if she brings you in.
Oh, yeah.
Because then, you know, it looks bad.
You put me in trouble. Don't do that.
Okay. We're not mentioning any names.
Yeah, but again, my Tuesday nights, comedy, Chicago comedy, DJ Tony and DJ Papi Cruz.
And I love that name. What's the DJ's name?
DJ Papi Cruz.
Hey, Papi.
Wednesday nights is Sessions in Windy City Indie, and Thursday nights is Sessions in Foundation Cabaret, and Friday nights is Elevate. So please come out.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And what's the date today?
Today's the 23rd.
Today is the
23rd. Yep.
And so let's see.
Next Wednesday. Perfect intro.
Yes. So next Wednesday is May 5th.
May 3rd.
Next Wednesday.
God, we can't get it together.
Is it a Thursday?
Time out.
Time out.
It's May 3rd.
Reverse.
It's May 3rd.
It is May 3rd, guys.
I got you.
That
listen.
Is a Wednesday. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Yep.
Wait, did you say a different day?
Thursday.
I thought
first.
It was a Thursday.
Oh, that's because I was doing Thursdays before.
You were doing Thursdays.
At Mr. Brown's Lounge, but that is no longer happening anymore. In case you didn't get the memo.
I didn't get the details of the memo, though.
We'll see.
Okay.
When the mics are off for real.
All right.
So, anyway. So May 3rd, Jerome, Croswell will be performing live in the Foundation Room at House of Blues. And also Molly and John. It's more cabaret singing. They'll be performing between 6 and 8, and Jerome will be performing between 8 and 10. Next Wednesday, May 3rd. So come up there. You get free live music, free live, great live music. It's 329 North Dearborn, inside the House of Blues, fourth floor. There's no cover, and you have to be 21 and over, please. Please, 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 please. Also, possibly May 5th, Friday? Possibly May 5th, Friday?
Possibly May 5th, Friday. I think we can make this happen.
Yeah?
I just need to look at my notes.
So, can I
announce it? It would be from 8 to 10. Let's just get that straight.
So, Friday, May 5th, and I'm going to confirm it with the artist, too. I wish I could have had her in here. Kiera. Yes, she will be performing.
She's amazing.
Yeah. You have seen her. Kiera Lanier.
Yes.
Yes. She's hot right now. She's popping up everywhere. But she will be performing. She doesn't know yet.
She doesn't know.
She knows.
But she's about
she
to.
She knows. Because
she
I already
know. She's
told
been
her.
Wanting to for a while.
I already told her. I said, hey, I'm going to make it happen. So she's going to be performing Friday, May 5th. From 8 to 10 in the Foundation Room as well. So, thank you all for joining in, for tuning in, Gypsy Love Radio, every Sunday from 10 to 12, q4.org. And I will see you guys next week. Thank you guys for joining. And you have another show, right? Let's throw it out there real quick again. May 10th, you said?
April 29th, coming up this Saturday at the 90 Mouse Cafe, Lincolnwood.
April 29th. I think we're tired.
Yeah.
Hola, Mercedes. Hey, you want to call in and sing a tune? Mercedes. Okay, so yeah, he will be playing April 29th.
Right.
At 90 Miles in Lincolnwood. Mm-hmm. What time?
9 p.m.
9 p.m.? Mm-hmm. All right. Girl, you better call in with a song. Anyway, anyway, all right, everybody.
All right.
Thank you for tuning in.
Signing
See
out.
You guys next week. Over and out.
Over and out.